Rita's a beta slasher.
How's telling everyone about a dummy breakout going to catch the lagger?
Because we tell everybody about the breakout, but we tell everybody a different version of the plan.
What am I being charged with?
I thought that was obvious. Murder.
Hey, Lou, I found it. It's in the lock at the gate near the staff room.
The only trouble is I can't remember who I gave that info to.
I can. It was Lexi bloody Patterson.
Crikey, are you sure?
I should have known she was covering.
What are you going to do to her?
What I'd do to any lagger. I'm going to kill her.
Wait till you get into those bars. I reckon I'm really going to clean up. She probably caused a car accident with that wheelie. Hey, watch it, will you?
Good advice, kid. Try it sometime.
What's up with her?
I don't know.
Some people have no sense of humour.
Now, have you told them all?
Well, yeah, I've told them all to pass the word on.
Hang on. You told them it was Patterson that was the lagger and what we were going to do to her, right?
Well, I told them all what you said to tell them. It's just all this stuff about knocking her off. Some of them don't like it. Couldn't we just...
You're not backing out, are you?
No. I already copped an extra 10 for murder, remember?
Yeah, and you won't enjoy none of them if you don't stop hassling me.
So what's happening? Are we still going ahead with it?
This lagger's not going to get away with it.
So we're still going to kill her?
Oh, do we have to? Look,
shut up! Dobbin. Look, I've got to think about it, all right?
I thought that lagging was the mortal sin around here. Apparently I was wrong.
It is. But I've got to think of me backup. Look, I don't want them thinking they're not getting a say.
I already told you.
And I'm not crawling either. Top dog still gets a final say.
Look, perhaps you shouldn't go ahead with it. I mean, you might lose some of the women for not being strong, but on the other hand, you should keep the others.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. It's just that some of the women mightn't think you're quite the top dog you're supposed to be if you back down after saying you'd kill Lexi.
Well, it really wasn't out of my way. Besides, I'm ahead of schedule.
You're a terrible liar, but I'm glad to see you.
You all right?
Yes, of course. Sit down. I'll get another cup.
Well, actually, I did have an ulterior motive. I was wondering if you could give me a few tips on how to reduce two mountains of paperwork to one all by yesterday.
Oh, you'll get the hang of it.
I put Egbert back in reception. I think it'll help.
Oh, I got a card from Ben and Pippa. Pip sounds like the typical bride. Everything wonderful.
Thanks.
No word of when they'll be coming back, though. Wouldn't be surprised if they decide... stay over there indefinitely.
Why don't you go over there? Join them. They'd love to see you.
Oh, interrupt the honeymoon? Can you see Pip's face? Oh, Anne, really?
Do you have any plans? Anything you really want to do?
No, not really. Oh, I thought I might go back into welfare, but I don't know. I've been there, done that. Maybe I should try something completely different. Just not sure.
Well, don't have to make any decisions just yet. I mean, who knows what might turn up when you're least expecting it.
Yes, I suppose you're right. Let's hope so.
So tell them you want to work.
But I don't.
Not really. Sure you do. I want you handy for when we make a move.
All right, if you say so.
Ask to get put in the kitchen. That's where we are today.
Or is it tomorrow?
Oh, today. And don't stuff up.
You know that she's a tough bitch with no conscience, but... Lou's calling her a lagger. Doesn't seem like her.
You've been around a long time. I thought you would have learned to trust no one, not till they proved themselves. Especially not hotheads like her.
Yeah, but lagging?
Oh, Lou reckons she's got proof.
Oh, we all know what sort of proof Lou needs.
Yeah, right. My policy is you don't trust anyone till you find out for yourself.
Hey, you wouldn't go along with Lou's planning, would you? Oh, God, I've been killing somebody just for lagging.
Well, weirder things have happened. I'm pretty close to it myself once or twice.
Killing a lagger?
More like a stooling. We had one ride with a gang once, except it turned out he was setting us up for a rumble with the other gang. We thought something was pretty strange when he shot through just before the action.
And what happened?
Beat the living hell out of the White Knights, that's what. Caught up with the stoolie later.
And what did you do?
Well, let's just say it took a long time to get the skid marks off his face.
What gives?
I don't know.
Hey, come on, everyone. If you want to put some last-minute dough on the book, you better hurry, because I'm closing it real soon. Don't all speak at once.
Don't worry about it. Get something to eat.
Got a hearty high for an old mate? Have I got BO or something?
Move away, son.
Are you okay?
Not now, mate. We've got to go to court.
But she's my mother, for God's sake. Please.
What do you reckon, Sarge?
Okay, but make it quick. You start the car.
Oh, thank you.
Mum, I tried to get in to see you, but they wouldn't let me. They said the charge was murder. What's going on?
Peter, are you all right, love? I've been so worried.
Forget about me. It's what's happening to you. I'm not going to let you do this. I'm going to tell
her. Oh, no! And there's no need, anyway.
What do you mean, no need?
Not when they know what sort of man your father was, and you're my witness. No buts, please.
Okay, that's enough. Let's go.
Look, I might have to go to prison just until the trial, and I don't want you worrying about me.
Well, of course
now,
I'm
listen,
worried.
Listen, I'll be all right. I'll survive.
She'll be me in there, not you.
No! Do you know what they might do to a good-looking young boy like you in jail? I can't let that happen. I'll be all right.
Wait a second.
What is it, son?
Just look after her, okay?
Yes.
Connor's, Governor.
Right, bring her in. I've been told you smashed the window in your cell. Got another one of those notes, did you?
I want to know why it happened.
Well, Gov, there was this fly driving me up the wall.
Connor,
it was.
I am not interested in your stories.
Dirty little buggers. It landed right on the window, didn't it? Never did know me own strength. I just grabbed a magazine and whopped at one.
Right. Now perhaps you'll give me the real version.
Oh, well, I thought that one was pretty good myself.
What sort of too cocky if I were you, Connors? I am not in the mood for troublemakers.
Me neither. So how about I just say I'm sorry and we forget about the whole thing?
How about we say that you'll have the money to repair the window deducted from your pay?
You're the boss.
You'll be well advised to remember that. You will also lose visiting privileges for the next 5 days, Mrs. Radcliffe.
Oh,
and one other thing. Until I get a glazier in here, you'll have to put up with the bare bars instead of a window. Perhaps that'll teach you not to be so reckless next time.
I'll cope.
He'll put the carrots on till 2:15 and check the meat.
Yeah, every 15 minutes. Look, we know. We can handle it, all right?
Right. Oh, the batter.
Oh, bugger the batter. Go on, you'll be late if you don't get a move on.
I know. And I can't believe that Mrs. Barry's coming home. It's been such a nightmare. God knows how you could be so cruel.
Look, you better get going, hadn't you? She'll be waiting for you.
Well, I'll see you all later. And don't forget to pick up Mrs. Morris's tray.
Go!
But he's going to start crying.
Yeah, well, lucky for you, he hasn't got the guts to do what he'd like to do.
Yeah, a lot of others feel the same way.
Well, then they better stop thinking that way.
Yeah, well, I was just telling you what I've been hearing from the girls.
Well, then you better start putting them right, hadn't you? Now go and get me the beater, I need it.
I didn't mean to cause any
Forget
infection.
It. I've been kicking around a few ideas about getting Patterson.
So have I. It's not going to be easy, though.
Mm. Won't be too popular, either.
Not that I'm interested, but how do you figure that?
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? I mean, none of the girls want Lexi dead. So you go against the majority, they think they can't trust you. And nobody wants a top dog they can't trust.
Well, that's a bit of a turnaround, isn't it? That lagging little bitch was going to use your guts for garters. Now you're trying to save her neck.
Yeah. No, I'm not. I think she needs the hiding of a life, but I don't hold with killing.
Well, it doesn't matter much what you mean, does it? Because I'm running the joint, so what I say goes.
Oh, well, I'm going to go and get Mrs. Morris's tray. That's if it's all right with you.
Nosy buggers we can do without, Wyndham.
Ow!
Now, what's wrong with you?
Oh, well, your switch is wonky. I got a shock.
You all right?
Yeah, could be dead. Bloody thing.
Well, open your eyes. Pringle put that there weeks ago.
Oh, God, I got so used to seeing it, I forgot what it said. We should get the screws to fix it before someone carks it.
Yeah.
Especially if they weren't warned.
Patterson.
That's right.
I got a bone to pick with you, you old bag. What the hell are you doing telling everybody? The whole prison's down on me because of you.
It's got nothing to do with me. You don't understand.
Oh, sure I do.
I'm warning you. You've got enemies.
Yeah, thanks to you. Look, okay, I made a mistake. The way you're getting back at me stinks.
I'm not getting back at you. Now shut up and listen to me. They know it's you.
It's me what? What lies have you been telling about me now?
They know you're the lagger.
What crap?
No, they do. Kelly wants you dead.
Bull, you're making it up.
No.
How the hell can they know I'm the lagger when it's not me? You're full of it.
I'm trying.
Oh, I know, but you're trying. You dob me in with a story like that and I'll fix you, I promise.
Lexi, please.
Just keep away from me, you crazy old bat.
Sorry, my boy, I was sure we'd get bail.
What's going to happen to him, Mr. Page?
Your mother's a strong woman, Peter. It won't be long until a trial. I'm sure she can cope.
Look, you don't understand. It wasn't meant to happen. I didn't... It was an accident.
Of course it was. Once your mother tells the jury, they'll know it too. Now, try not to worry. We'll have her home again in no time.
You're supposed to be doing for me?
Yeah, I haven't had a chance. Too busy sucking up to the screws, eh?
That's not fair. Look, you promised me you'd get into those files.
And I will. I can't just waltz up to the screws and say, excuse me, I want to check someone's sentence.
No, but you can look for a chance instead of piddling around with stupid bloody invoices.
Cut it out, Lex. I'm doing me best.
Yeah, well, it's not good enough.
Well, it's going to have to be. It's all you're going to get, so you can just lump it.
Look, just get into the files like you said.
Surprised you didn't get her pal Morris to look into it for her.
All right, it doesn't take four to clean the tables. Fisher and Young, come and unpack the deliveries. Kelly, Wilder, get a move on.
Yeah. Geez, Patterson must be itchy. She really gave Egbert a hammering.
Shame, though.
What?
Well, it's a perfect opportunity to convince the other women to kill the bitch. But I guess you've already thought about that.
Keep going. See if we're on the same track, eh?
Another note about Julie.
Great minds, huh?
This way we've got lots of witnesses to prove she was giving Julie a hard time.
Nothing like a bit of phantom lagging to catch a phantom lagger, eh? Once I've told the others about Patterson dobbing in her best mate, they'll be begging me to kill her.
No, don't you dare!
Look, just go round there. She really needs the company. Well, use your ingenuity. Tell her anything. Tell her you need some help. Oh, right, and don't tell her I called you, all right? Okay. Thanks.
Slattery, can I use that calculator just to double check?
Sure. I don't know how you do it all in your head anyway.
Here, have a look at this.
What? Where did this come from?
Never mind. Should be near the files at all.
Not that I've noticed.
I think we're going to have to keep a very close eye on her. Someone in there is making our job a whole lot easier.
I'll file these, will I?
No. Make yourself scarce, Egbert.
Where will I go?
Wait outside the gate till the induction's over.
Right, McCormick, stand on the white line.
Please,
Could I just make a phone
call? No, you cannot. You have to be inducted first.
Oh, my son, you see, he'll be so worried.
You will be allowed one phone call per week, and not until you've been inducted. Now, stop wasting my time.
I'll take this.
Thanks.
Oh, that's got personal things in it.
It's okay. We won't hurt them.
But I...
It's procedure, McCormick. You better get used to it. We're not in the habit of stealing personal belongings.
Oh, I didn't mean that. It... Oh, never mind.
Let's turn around. Your name is Nancy May McCormick. Answer the question.
Sorry, yes, that's right.
You've been charged with murder and you'll be held on remand until such a time as you stand trial to answer the charges. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks. See you next time.
Come on, over here.
Empty your pockets and we'll check through these things.
Go on, the quicker you learn to do as you're told, the easier it'll be for you.
That's all, I'm afraid.
I'll put it over here with these other things for the moment.
I am sorry. It's just that I've never been to prison before.
And with a murder charge hanging over your head, you'll have plenty of time to get used to it.
He's a nice-looking boy. Is that your son?
Yes. Could I have that, please?
You'll get your belongings back in due course, if the governor says so.
What happens next?
Well, you sign for all that, then you have a shower, and then you have a medical.
So I told him I had the trots and got out of work, just so as I could speak to you. So are you behaving yourself?
Of course I am. Don't you trust me?
Have you forgotten why I'm in here? I bet you're laying everything in sight.
The hell I am. I dropped a valve on the way to the pub last night.
Oh, buggered the piston, did you?
Cracked it. I had to stay up all night fixing the bloody thing.
I can't remember you staying up all night fixing me.
Listen, Rita, you didn't need that much bloody fixing.
That's right. Bikes first, Sheila second, eh?
Well, yeah, maybe. Look, what about I come by and see you this afternoon? Get a tongue whistle in while the screws ain't looking.
I can't. Gov's knocked off all my visitors for 5 days.
Oh, bugger it. I was going to bring your jacket back, too.
You fixed it. That's fantastic. Look, why don't you bring it in anyway? I mean, you could leave it at the front desk.
Okay. Listen, Ree. You know I really miss you.
Sure, I miss you too, lover. And the gang. I wish I could have a drink with you, Zool.
Well, I don't know about the drinks, but you can talk to everybody tonight if you like.
How do you mean?
Well, they're all coming over to the clubhouse tonight, and we'll get on the CB and have a real party. What do you reckon?
Fantastic! Oh, getting this thing in here is the best thing that's happened. Hey, Slash. Why don't you tell me what you'd do to me if you were here? Give me a real turn on, huh?
Am I allowed to talk in these airwaves like that, Reed?
Well, you took your time.
I couldn't get dressed. Somebody took my clothes while I was in the shower.
Yes, I took them.
Well, you, I don't understand.
Procedure. They're being searched along with your belongings. You'll get fresh ones in a minute.
Searched? What for? I empty my pockets.
You wouldn't be the first person to try and smuggle in money or drugs.
Drugs?
Yes, that's right, drugs. I dropped the towel.
Oh, no, no, please.
It's called a body search.
No, I'm not hiding anything. I'm not in here for drugs. That's not why I'm in here.
I know why you're here. Now drop the towel or are you waiting for me to warm my hands?
Right, my girl. You've had it.
You were given a privilege that very few of the women have. You were allowed trustee status, given interesting work to do, and this is how you abuse it.
I'm sorry, honest.
You'll be a lot more sorry if you don't tell us exactly what you were doing.
Well, I didn't really have a reason. I was just curious.
Egbert, this is the second time you've been caught. It will also be the last. As from now, you will cease to work in reception. And on top of that, you will go to solitary for the next 24 hours.
I expect everyone to toe the line. And I mean everyone.
I'm sorry.
Take her out.
Come on, Egbert.
New prisoner's here when you're ready.
Bring her in.
Right. McCormick.
Hey! You never believe what I just saw.
Oh, don't tell me you shat her.
What?
No! Julie. Hey, they're dragging her off to the pound. Looks like your plan worked, eh, Lou?
Well, of course it did.
Now, do you reckon you can do something right without mucking it up for a change?
Sure. What do you want me to do?
Keep your voice down for a start. And then you can move your bum and start spreading the word Patterson dobbed her best mate in.
Oh, but I've just been to the dummy. The screw won't let me.
Then start here, on those two morons.
Yeah, sure.
If she had half a brain, it'd be lonely.
Don't go getting ahead of yourself. You're still on probation, remember?
Sure, whatever you say.
Yeah, whatever I say.
Of course, if you decide not to work, you'll be free to use the recreation room or remain in your cell.
I understand.
Now, are there any questions?
A bit pointless, really.
McCormick, you're only on remand. There's no need to make it any harder on yourself.
Why should I? I'm sure your officers can do that.
That's not the case. The officers are here to
help. Oh, yes, I do have a question. Now that I'm here, what are my rights?
All prisoners' rights are included in that booklet I gave you.
Oh, good. Does it say anything about the treatment I've received so far? Does it tell me how to retain my dignity after what I've just been through?
I know the induction process isn't very pleasant.
I've seen butchers handle carcasses with more care.
There is a good reason for it. If there were no body search, weapons or drugs could be brought into the prison.
And your officers wouldn't get their job satisfaction. I'm sure there are good reasons for it.
Do you wish to lay a complaint against the officer that searched you?
No. I just want to get all this over and done with.
We are here to help you. Believe me, I do know what you're feeling. And if there's anything I can do to help, I will.
My son's photo, can I have that?
You brought it with you?
That was taken from me at reception.
I'll see you have it in your cell.
Thank you.
Got a cup of tea for an old digger?
Etty!
Stress, me tongue's been hanging out for an hour waiting for this cuppa.
Surely it didn't take you as long as that to get here.
Well, it shouldn't have. We went past me tram stop. Oh. So I had to walk. Hey, they're not the cups.
They're not?
No, I left two warming up on the sink.
I thought you were just washing them out. They're dirty.
Oh, a bit of old tea wouldn't hurt us. Hang on. Oh, gee, the way you keep this place for credit to you, you know. So clean. Where's the tea towel?
Cupboard under the sink.
Honestly, if you see the way my girls mess up their rooms, it's enough to put you off your Wheaties. Here we go. You be your mother, dear. I'll have white, thanks.
How many girls have you got in the flats?
Nine. Make that eight. When I'm at a moonlight fit on Saturday night, silly little bugger reckons the place was as bad as Blackmore. I really do need some help, you know.
Are all the girls ex-prisoners?
Well, five of them are. But this poor kid, she was down on her uppers, and all I was doing was trying to show her how to make a dole check go further.
Oh, dear. TV dinners and pre-packed food, right?
Oh, how'd you know?
I used to be in family welfare before I went to Wentworth. Saw it happening all the time.
Yeah, well, you can't blame them, can you? There's no one to show them. Anyway, I gave her my recipe for Susso stew. That's what we used to eat during the war.
2 pounds of minced meat to 1 pound of vegetables. Served with bread and rice should last at least a week.
There you go again. Gee, I do wish you'd come and help me.
Oh, Etty, I really couldn't.
But why couldn't you, Mrs. Reynolds? You know it all. I'm not kidding. Some of these poor kids have got one foot in a slammer and the other on a banana skin. One push and they're back in the nick. I can't do it all on my own.
So Meg Morris sent you to see me?
Oh, funny thing to say. Oh, I must say, those biscuits do look very
nice. All right, Etty. I knew Meg was behind it the minute I opened the door.
You're not going to go crooked, are you? She only sent me here because she was worried about you.
Yes, I know, and I really am glad to see you. I've been worried about how you were getting on.
Well, if you're that worried, you'd come and give me a hand. At least come and have a look. I mean, I might feel unwanted and unloved again. And then wham! I'm back in Wentworth again with all my mates.
All right, I'll come and look at it. But that's all.
Well, taking the day off, are we, Connors? Decided not to work.
You've got to be joking. I've been on the throne all morning. The throne, the bog, you know. You don't want me to say I've been powdering my nose, do you?
I see. Sick, are we?
You've got it too.
I reckon it's the food.
Keep pushing your luck, Connors. I could have you on a charge for just being here. You know that, don't you?
Well, you better hurry up. Because the minute you came round the corner, I got this sudden urge to go again.
Oh, no. Not now. I'm going to save you for the big one. At last, I've got something to look forward to. Job satisfaction has taken on a whole new meaning.
She's having a bag.
Right. Well, come on, you lot, what do you reckon?
Well, if you ask me, I think you're a bloody idiot.
Why? You're the first one she tipped the bucket on.
Yeah, I'd punch her bloody face in.
Oh, I suppose that's fair enough, but she wants to kill her.
She's not the only one.
God, strike her light, don't make me laugh.
What's so funny?
You silly great lump. If you had an original thought, you'd die of fright.
Jessie, she's a lagger. She lagged on a best friend.
Yeah, Roz and Lorna reckon Shook really got stuck into her.
Blame her, the bitch.
Yeah, well, a couple of mates had a blues, so leave it at that.
But what about the next poor bugger she lags on?
All right, come on. Let's get lunch ready before lights out, eh?
Just taking the garbage out, Miss Hagen.
Okay. Mrs. Slattery's taking over in a few minutes, so smarten yourselves up.
Right. Well, are you with me or not?
I am.
So am I. Anyone would think you were the only one here.
Shut up, Lurch. What about you two? Good. Well, you better finish setting up the dining room.
It worked.
Maybe I can use you after all.
Oh, come off it. I did some of it too.
Yeah, and it still worked. Now check Hagen.
Gone.
Good. We'll go and get Patterson quick. Oh, but Luke,
don't argue. Just do it.
What's the matter with you, Shorty? Got a face like a skid mark.
That's what's wrong. Look at him. All of a sudden, I'm poison, eh?
They're working.
I'll be buggered. I just got the same deal from the rest of the block. And nobody's saying why.
I know the feeling.
Don't worry about it. It's Kelly, isn't it? That's why you're doing it. Well, you can all just get knotted.
Ah, go for it, kiddo.
Oh, and you sit on it.
Hey, behave yourself. Hey, Patterson, we need some tea towels in the kitchen.
You're not helpless, are you? There they are.
Oh, bugger. It's your job, not mine.
Oh, why not? Better than hanging around with this bunch of nerds anyhow.
Be careful.
Yeah, no worries. It's okay as long as it's switched off. Check the corridor, will you?
It's all clear.
Okay.
Oh, last time I fall for that flaming job. The lid on that thing must weigh a ton.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Oh, I just spilled some water, that's all.
Look, is the mop still outside?
No, it's in the cool room. Haven't finished in there yet.
Well, get it for me, will you? I've got to plan this in.
Be careful, you don't wet that powerful.
Yes.
What's going on?
I just take some window, Melissa. Push that across, will you?
Yeah, why not? You're getting a bit cold in there, are you?
Who's that? Is that you, Lexi?
Yeah, I'd come in and hug your hand, but the freak might get a bit jealous, you know?
Oh, you cheeky little bugger. Oh, my God. Lexi, get out of there, quick, quick! They're gonna kill you!
What are you doing?
Quick, get up on the table. Get in the corridor to keep me, will you?
In fact, very good for your age.
There's nothing wrong with me. This is a waste of time.
Far from it. It's our job to look after you now.
Well, then give me something for my stomach, please. I feel nauseous.
I'd be surprised if you didn't. Everybody does their first day. Now, take your clothes off, will you? You still feel the same way tomorrow? We'll have a close...
Come on now. Quickly, please. You don't want to be here all day. Why do I have to take my clothes off? There's no need. I'm perfectly well. You've just told me.
I need to check you for head and body lice. Now, do as you're told, or I'll call an officer in.
Patterson's been electrocuted. She's in the kitchen. You, wait in the corridor. Hurry!
Oh, isn't it beautiful?
What, love?
Oh, the trees and the sky. Just seeing them, I suppose.
There was a time when I didn't think I would be, you know.
Oh, I told you, it only lasts a week.
Oh, I've seen too many Betty Davis movies to fall for that
one. Okay, now, remember what I told you. Take it easy.
Yeah.
And any problems before your first visit back, call me.
Right.
I did give you my home number, didn't
you? You certainly did. Now, come along, Joycey, and watch your head.
What's this about a home phone number?
Never mind, love, I'll tell you later. Now, come along.
No, tell me now.
Well, I promised Steve I'd help him with his research. I said I'd call him off a fan and one willing to talk to him.
Like who?
Well, like to an ex-prisoner or an officer. Now, oh. Come on, love, sit down before you fall down.
Why are people always so bossy with invalids?
In you go.
That's it.
I've got a confession to make.
Oh.
Well, first I didn't have much faith in you. It was Joycey.
No one good enough for your Joycey. Well, I would have felt the same. Forget it. And I'll look forward to hearing from you.
You certainly will. I don't know how or what, but we'll think of something.
Okay.
Mervyn.
Coming, love, coming.
Bye.
Bye.
Hold her arm, will you, pet? Nearly finished. It's all right, Lexi. You might be a bit sore, but everything's all right.
What happened?
You had an electric shock, don't you remember? Well, lucky for you, Jessie Windham was there. She probably saved your life. Just relax. The doctor will be here soon.
Jessie. Oh, my hands. Just
look, would you check and see if the doctor's arrived yet?
Yeah. Let's see. Mm-hmm.
In.
Oh, you're not serious.
What?
Well, this room is so cold.
This is a prison, McCormick, not a hotel.
Well, how long do I have to stay here?
You heard the governor. Until tomorrow, and then you'll be put with the other women.
But there's nothing here, Miss Ferguson. Look, you can see for yourself. There's just a bed, a blanket, and a pillow.
This is a solitary cell. You've been put here for your own protection.
Protection? Who against?
McCormick, you've been charged with murder. And according to the experts, you'll undergo a period of mental instability. It's our job to see that you don't hurt yourself. It's as simple as that.
You mean suicide?
You wouldn't be the first. Now, McCormick, you obviously believe in speaking your mind. That's good. Let me give you a word of advice. You backchat the officers, you'll find yourself on a charge. Do it to the other women, and you'll be begging to be put back in here. It's up to you.
Poor little bugger. Are you sure the doctor...
He gave her a thorough examination. He said everything's going to be all right. Mind you, he did say if you hadn't been there, it would have been a different story. Where'd you learn to do resuscitation?
Oh, hell. I suppose I could tell you, but I think you're a bit young. Well, let's just say that in my time, I've had to revive quite a few of my clients. Yeah. Coronary interruptus, they called it. Poor loves. The flesh was willing, but the heart was a bit weak, you know.
Yes, well, look, don't stay too long and don't disturb her. The doctor's given her something to sleep.
Yoo-hoo! Can you hear me, love?
Oh, Jess, thanks. You never told me.
Oh, thanks be blowed. I'm not here for that. Do you know what happened? Oh, don't go to sleep on me now. Do you know?
Accident and I slipped.
Accident? My Aunt Fanny. Kelly tried to kill you. Kelly Lurch. And Wilder. Now listen to me. Listen. So long as you're in here, you're as safe as houses. So stay sick as long as you can. Oh, listen to me. Don't go snoozing off again, love. Oh, not now. Oh, listen to me. Bugger it. Bloody doctors.
Hi, Mervyn. How's the patient?
Difficult, argumentative and restless. But very well, so who cares?
Oh, good. I might call round and see her after work.
Oh, she'd love that. And tell her the place can get along without her, will you? Oh,
will do. Although we could have done with her this morning. Had a rather nasty accident in the kitchen.
Why, what happened?
Oh, well, you know that faulty PowerPoint. I'm afraid Lexi Patterson touched the cord and, well, you can imagine the rest.
Is she all right?
Yes, yes, she's fine, Mervyn.
Oh, she's all right, is she? What's going to happen next time? Do you know how long that PowerPoint's been like that?
Yes, I do.
2 weeks now. I spoke to Mrs. Reynolds about it 2 weeks ago. Now look what's happened.
Mervyn, the department. Don't
damn
just
the department.
Come whenever you...
When the girls are in that kitchen, they're my responsibility. So I'm going to do something about it. I'm going to pay for an electrician myself.
Mervyn, please. Look, it's already been done. Now just calm down. Not only that, but they've agreed to give us a permanent handyman. As a matter of fact, I'm interviewing people for the job tomorrow.
I'm sorry, I'm a bit of a worrier, but tomorrow? You're seeing people tomorrow?
Yes, why?
Oh, well, nothing, no reason.
Will you get it, Mother? I'm in the spa. Mother? Stephen Ryan.
Steve? Mervyn Pringle. No, she's fine. I'm calling about that research you wanted to do. Just how far are you prepared to go? Because I think I have the perfect answer.
Oh, there's no limits, Mervyn. Oh, it's very important. What have you got in mind?
No, I won't tell you now, but could you drop Brian sometime tonight? Good. It might be a bit crazy, but I think it's just what you want.
Bad news for you girls. She's going to be all right. I wouldn't if I were you. There's a screw outside.
Ronnie?
Yeah, Radcliffe. Oh, we'll just have to make it a quiet accident, won't we?
Quiet accident? Use your head, girl. Not just for hanging your hat on.
Quiet, loud, what's the diff? She's still gonna lag.
She doesn't know what happened. How can she lag? Look, I'd rather not.
Mervyn's
but if I
coming.
Have to...
He's talking to a screw.
Make up your minds.
You'll keep, Wyndham.
Just a reminder, Kelly. Josie Bibb and Dinah in C Block were some of my best girls on the outside, and they'd hate to know that you've been threatening me.
Oh, there you are, Jessie. I've just heard. Congratulations, you're a hero.
Oh, I don't go hanging any medals on me yet.
And why not? It was a very risky business. Thank God you and Lexi are mates, eh?
Me? Mates with that little lager? Now I've heard everything. What do you reckon, Luke?
What's going on?
One of Connor's bikey friends dropped in with a leather jacket. Wouldn't take no for an answer. We told him she couldn't have visitors. You should have heard the performance. Don't waste your time. He wouldn't sign in.
Oh, couldn't, more likely. Yeah, honestly, he looked like a reject from a fur factory.
Would you like me to give it to her?
I know what I'd like to do with it.
Just leave it in her cell. We're not going to be running around after her sort.
Give it to me. I'll drop it in on my way to C Block.
You should have seen the way he handled it. It was like something precious.
Yeah, they're funny like that.
All right, let's take a vote on it. Turnovers. Apple or apricot? Jessie?
Oh, apple for me, thanks, Merv. Apricots bring me out in spots.
Oh, well, let's make it apricot then. She might die or something.
That's enough of that. You can't be civil. But where's the sugar? It was here a moment ago.
Ronnie and Tina took it to the dining room to fill up the bowls.
But it's brown sugar. Stupid girls.
Right, let's get the bitch.
Don't be ridiculous. He'll be back in a minute.
Oh, well, bugger off then if you're scared.
Shut up, Lurch. She's right. Lay off.
What's going on here? You two on together or something?
You want to repeat that?
Yeah, well, she shouldn't call me ridiculous.
Ah, fight, you buggers. I hate peace.
If you want to take on half a C Block, you do it on your own, all right?
Yeah, well, you said you were going to do something.
Well,
about...
we will when I say.
All right, come on. We'll start again. Right, Wilder, you can clean the mess off the bench.
Oh, I can't, Mr. Pringle. The bin's full.
Then empty it.
Want to help me, Jessie?
Oh, yes. I'd love a breath of fresh air. Can I finish this first, Ruth?
Take your time, Jessie. Wilder can help you until you're ready.
To help.
Opened the door, didn't I? Besides, that's not what you want me out here for, is it?
I don't understand you, Jessie. You've got brains. You'd leave most of those idiots in there for dead.
You only say that because it's true.
No, seriously. I don't understand why you're doing all this for Lexi.
Why not? I like the kid.
After what she's done to you, I... You're not a lesbian, are you?
Are you the lagger? Well?
You can't be serious.
Deadly.
But I was lagged on myself.
Big deal. A couple of pills, and as a result, you become too icy to loo and get the protection from the other women. And boy, lady, do you need protection.
Listen, Wyndham, I didn't get you out here to listen to rubbish like that.
I know you didn't, so I'll leave you to it. Don't be long.
You know, if there's one thing I hate more than a screamer's, it's wearing clothes that have been in the dryer. They stink. And I don't reckon that washing powder's any good either. I mean, check this. Vivid grey.
Should be doing TV commercials, Connor.
Oh, g'day, Miss Ferguson. Getting your fair share?
Your jacket's arrived. It's in your cell.
Beauty! Back in a minute, girls.
Not until you've finished unloading that dryer.
But it'll only take a minute.
You heard me. The dryer.
You heard me. The dryer. No, I'm too feminine. That's my trouble.
Well, I'm cute, Connors.
Throw on me skin, what of it?
Skin? Oh, you mean this.
Okay, I'll buy. What's going on?
Now, Connors, it's a funny thing about this job. It ruins your sense of humour.
Give me the jacket, Ferguson.
I've tried to see the funny side of you putting me in that dryer.
The jacket? I didn't do it.
Oh, yes, you did. And I said you'd be sorry.
You're not using your head, Ferguson. Someone must have seen it brought in. You gotta give it to me.
Right.
You stinking slaty!
Don't thank me yet, Connors.
When the children get hold of you, they're gonna do that to your face!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. Christmas too, when morning comes around.